In the last few videos, we talked a lot of theories and precautions that we need while designing a printed circuit board. In this video, we'll start with bringing the components from the schematic editor to the PCB layout editor and start working on our first printed circuit board. I've already shown what we are going to build in the beginning of this series, so most of the features and the mechanical design is already done. In this video, we'll just take the design for the reference and we'll figure out where to place the components around the PCB. When I said we'll refer to the 3D model, I don't mean that we'll use the exact dimensions and try to make a PCB. Instead, we'll just start with all the basics of PCB layout editor, and in the upcoming videos, we'll optimize the PCB so that it can fit inside the 3D model. But for now, let's start with defining the shape of the PCB within KiCad. If you remember correctly from the PCB stackup video, we can do this in the edge cut layer. So make sure you select the edge cut layer and then click on the circle tool. Now we'll draw a circle on the document of any radius. Now to open the properties for this circle, there are three different ways. Either you can use the property manager over here, or you can hover your mouse over the circle and right click, then click on properties. Or the one I always recommend is use the keyboard shortcut letter E. By using these properties, we can change the location of the circle on the document. And by using these properties, we can change how the circle looks on the document. For now, let's just stick to radius, and I'll change the radius to 30 mm. And along with this, I make sure I selected the lock property. This will make sure we don't move the circle accidentally or resize them. And you can see once the property is applied, I don't have access to the circle anymore and I won't be able to select it. But if you want to apply some changes to this shape, we can do that by going to the bottom right corner and under selection filter, click on locked items. Now we can select the circle again and edit the properties. This selection filter will help in selecting only the required items and it will prevent users from selecting unwanted feature of the PCB. In this case, I'll make sure to turn off the locked selection. It's not mandatory, but this will prevent me from accidentally changing the locked values. Now going back to the PCB, we can quickly verify that we have defined the shape of the PCB on the 3D viewer by using the shortcut Alt plus 3. This will be the output of the 3D viewer. And the output will be similar only if the shape is on the edge cut layer. If the shape is drawn on another layer, KiCad will try to automatically draw the edge cut layer based on the content we put on the document. Since we have the base ready, all we need to do is get the components and place it within this circle. It should be pretty easy as we converted all our symbols into footprints in one of our previous video. On the top toolbar, click on the Update PCB button. This menu will help in importing all the symbols with footprints into the PCB editor. Here, just make sure all the three options are checked. And if you like to know what each one of them does, you can just hover the cursor over them. And they'll show pretty good explanation about the options. Now with these settings, I'll just click on Update PCB and then hit Close. We can see the complete circuit is imported and moves along with the cursor. I'll just bring the cursor close to the circle and try to place within it. The circuit is a little chaotic now and not properly arranged. We need to arrange this component in such a way that it's easy to fit on the 3D design I have already done. For reference, you can download the 3D model from the link in the description. I hope you're already familiar with most of the tools on the editor. They are very similar to the schematic editor tools that we learned. So here I won't go into much detail how things work. So according to the design, it would be better if I place the cell holder on the back and place the microphone at the edge of the PCB, as it would be the first thing to be mounted on the 3D model. Then we'll follow it with a LDR. Then finally, the LED. We won't have much control over placement of these components because of the design choices that's made to implement the features. But we can move the other parts around and optimize the space occupied on the PCB. I hope you observe these thin lines going across the components. These are called ratlines. They correspond to how the components are connected in the schematic diagram. If it's annoying, we can turn it off by toggling this button. And if you're not a fan of straight lines, you can also toggle this button to change the way the ratlines are drawn. Sometimes these lines can be very confusing if you have way too many components. In that case, we can turn off all the ratlines and use this tool. This tool will draw ratlines only to the footprints that are selected, and you can remove them by clicking on the footprint again. But for now, the ratline informations are very much needed, so I'll bring them back. We can use the ratline information and place the components close to each other based on the connection. Overall, this looks pretty average, but if you have OCD like me, I hate how these components are not aligned. We can quickly fix this by selecting these resistors and then right click, go to align, and then we'll align it to left. I'll do the same thing again, go to align, but this time I'll select distribute and click on distribute vertically. And you can see we have even space between these components. Now using this feature, I'll align all the components around the PCB. Now the circuit looks a little bit better. Now we can quickly check how this appears on a real PCB by using the 3D viewer. So I'll just use the shortcut Alt plus 3. This somewhat looks good, but it looks very odd with the pin for mic and no 3D model for a few of the components. So let me quickly show how to add external 3D model to the PCB layout editor. Go to Grabcad and we'll search for the component. Seems like we have one suitable option. And I think we found the model. And we can just go to the downloads and you'll find a different file format. Make sure you download .stp or .step file. Click here and hit on download. Now going back to KiCad. Select the footprint where we want to assign the 3D model, then right click, click on properties. Now on the top, click on 3D model, and you can see the existing 3D model is missing. So we can just delete this, click on the plus icon, then click on the folder icon. Then select the file that we just downloaded. You can see the 3D model does not match the footprint. It's pretty easy to match it up using the tools on the left. First, I'll reduce the opacity a little and then use the offset to move the 3D model on the x-axis. And I'll just turn the model and try to align the pins to the footprint. Once that's done, I'll bring the opacity back and then hit OK. Now, when we go back to the 3D viewer, you can see the 3D model has been imported within KiCad. Now, I'll quickly do the same for the switch. Now the circuit looks way better. In the next video, we'll see how to make the connection between each one of these components and also try to make the whole circuit look a little prettier. Until then, if you have any questions or doubts, you can always reach out to us at PCBCupid Q&A. And also don't forget to subscribe and like the video. And if you think this KiCad 7 series is really helping you, consider sharing it to a friend who is really interested in this topic. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.